Hi friends, today we are going to discuss a case of knee injury with knee pain, acute onset, 15 days duration in a middle-aged female. Here is I am sharing the x-ray which shows mild varus but still not bone-on-bone disease with mild early osteoarthritis. On the MRI, it shows extrusion of the meniscus on the coronal and as you can say almost like a ghost sign on the sagittal images with a tear. On arthroscopic view, it showed a degenerative change in the medial compartment of the knee. It showed, as you can see in the video, there is avulsion of the posterior root of the medial meniscus with degeneration in the medial femoral condyle. So we go ahead for doing a posterior medial meniscus root repair. We first prepare the bed with a ring curette to take off the cartilage and have a bare bone for good bleeding. I like to do a little bit of burr so that the bone bleeds there and helps in healing. Then we with a jig, meniscus root jig, we do a 2.5 drilling. Then with an anti-grade device, we take a 0.9 mm suture tape and take bites through the meniscus and relay it through the shuttle through the suture in the tunnel down on the anteromedial cortex of the tibia and tie over the suture tape over a titanium endobutton. There you can see nice compression of the root back in place. We can chip off the small that flap of the meniscus there. Now it's nice and taut and it's covering the tibia as well. We go ahead and do the microfracture as well over the middle femoral condyle, where you can see the bare area on the middle femoral condyle. And we, for post-op rehab, we do not allow the patient to weight bear for a month or at least 4 weeks of non-weight bearing and then partial weight bearing for another 2 to 3 weeks before they can weight bear fully. So post-operatively, as you can say, post-microfracture, you can see the supercloid there, which ultimately turns into a fibrocartilage covering the condyle. Thank you.